Hi, goaltenders. As promised, the reverse VH. And we're going to talk a little bit about how it works here. But when you look at a reverse VH, you're looking at the goaltender, and this is only one variation. So try not to crucify me in these comments. But this is one really in tight movement where the goaltender gets the opportunity to really cover in low. If you look at the critical angles that you need when the puck's in tight, you need to be right over top of the puck. You see the goaltender leading with his eyes, getting to the middle, and then getting to that critical point where the head is leading the body. You can see the legs or the knees starting to come apart and then come back together on the other side, linking the whole process as a chain all the way through. We'll see it one more time again as the goaltender goes, sets up the backs or the lead leg, leans towards the save, and closes down on pucks. And the very last movement post to post is just a little bit of flexion with the ankle. One of the things I'm noticing in the National Hockey, these goaltenders going down and staying down, especially big goaltenders, they get into a position where they just drop down on their knees and stay there. And there's no need to do that. So watch this player go below the goal line, shoots it right off the mask of the goaltender. We're going to see it again from another angle. Goaltender is down. And I mean, he's human. Puck comes at your head, you're gonna turn away from it. And same one here where Michael Hutchinson is in net. You know, a very good shot. These guys are incredible. So as they break around the outside, they shoot from an almost impossible angle, but it's not impossible anymore. The goaltender goes down right at the bottom of the circle, which is way too early. That would have hit him right in Maple Leaf. So those things play a massive role. Let's look at those angles again, so you can see them, place them out here again, where you have the opportunity to see, you know, what the goaltender is looking at when the player is coming down. And you got to learn the timing mechanisms necessary to be successful in the reverse VH. So let's take a look again at what can be a difference maker in executing the reverse VH. You find the goaltender already down on the post. The player is close to the board, so you know right away he's not going to shoot. This player moves down below the goal line, clearly on the outside rink. There's no reason to go down, and there's no reason to be in an RVH on the outside of the rink. So you can see all the time in the world that that player has to do what he needs to do. Here in the Canuck process here, down the line, as soon as the player gets to the bottom of the circle, it's kind of the timing mechanism, I guess, Toronto's goalie coach identified as a place to go down. It's too early. It's right below the dot. And when you go down too early, it gives these guys an opportunity to score.